It all starts with a dead girl. Ever since I was little, I've had this dream. It's the end of summer. A girl is running through the woods. The moon, the scent of pines. And then the gunshot. It always felt so real. The blood on my cheek, the cold sweat running down my skin. I'd managed to convince myself it really happened. This scar of a memory. A part of me I could never fully understand. Well, that wasn't the only part. No wonder people used to think I was strange. If they only knew. That day when the phone rang, it was the hardest day of my life. The day I went home to say goodbye to my father. Dress him up for his last journey. Put him in a suit, fix his tie. Simple. Just the things he did every day. But looking through his stuff wasn't easy. I needed a moment to pull myself together. I was almost ready. I just had to find his special tie clip. Yeah. Nice to see you too. Jack's room. It's like he never... Damn it. Jack was part part of the Solidarity movement. He spent a few months in an internment camp, but even that couldn't dampen his fear. Come on, Jack. Where'd you put it? Okay. Let's do this the other way. Okay, I think that's it. Jack's waiting downstairs. Time to say goodbye. Jack was a humble, religious man. He ran a funeral home, and I'd help out whenever I could. It felt good to be useful. Keep hissing at me. Who do you think's gonna feed you now? I used to think I'd never fit in. But Jack, he didn't mind my weirdness. He kept telling me I was special. Looks nourishing. Here you go. What's your face? Glad to see you're still kicking around. I believe it's all still here. Oh, Jack. I guess I forgot about this one. I can do it now. That's too quick. It needs longer exposure. Ah, that's too quick. It needs longer exposure. missed my window. Now it's overexposed. Fluid. I need to apply it in the right order. We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers. Jack taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse. Jack's in the prep room. Huh, weird. I don't remember locking it. The key should be in the office. Here it is. not sure if I'm ready for this. Hey, Jack. Got your special clip? No. Where's your tie? Snazzy. You wouldn't have it any other way. I didn't expect this to be easy. I guess I didn't know what to expect. When things get personal, it just burns you from the inside out. Guess you're ready. But am I? Oh, can't you people read? The sign says closed. You felt it too, huh? And then it happened, as it did so many times before, just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse.
Right, my child.
I...
happen to see my notebook, did you, darling? My memory's a bit fuzzy. So much for aging gracefully. Where is that?
Listen, Jack. You should probably get some rest. Forget the notebook.
Oh, no, no. I've got so much work, my dear.
It's okay,
Jack. I can't just...
What? Let it go. It's not important.
You are crying. What's wrong, dear? Why is it so cold in here? Where is that damn soap?
It's okay, Jack. It's okay.
My sweet little Marianne. What would I ever do without you?
Jack. Don't worry about it. It's time to get some rest.
Oh, Marianne.
Yeah?
No. I'm worried about the surgery. When I'm at the hospital, are you sure you're going to be all right?
Yes, Jack. It's going to be fine.
You know, I promised myself once I would never let anything happen to you. Not while I'm around.
I'll be fine. I promise.
No risky stuff, then. Huh? All right?
All right, Jack. Now, get some rest.
I need, though. Yes, yes. Be good, Marianne. I love you, my child. I've loved you since the moment you walked into my life. Remember that.